speak for a postman and tearing his trousers off with his bare teeth. In his defense, he told the court, "It's hard to tell the difference when they take their hats off." "I wonder who that is at 11 o'clock in the morning," she thought. But cautiously opening the door, instead of being turbaned roughly as she expected, she found a very nice young man. "Mrs. Pench, you've won the car contest. Would you like the Triumph Spitfire or 3,000 in cash?" he smiled. Mrs. Pench took the money. "What will you do with it all? Not that it's only in my business," he did. "I think I'll become an alcoholic," said Betty. The geranium behind me cheered, his face painted with gay cabalistic symbols, 6'8" and police sock, Jeff Paul looked jolly convincing as he sweated and grunted through a vigorous twist routine of the front of Lego Big Ella. His hot sewage trousers flapped wildly over his enormous plastic sandals as he jumped and gyrated towards a long-haired man.
"Excuse me, man, I've written a baby, then turn me on," he had suggested.
As if by magic, dozens of truncheons appeared and mercilessly thrashed him. Poor Jeff, what a turn up for the books. Much as he hated arguments of any kind of unpleasantness, one shared thought things had gone too far. Returning for a weekend in Clapton, he found that his neighbour had driven enormous hedge dividing their gardens into the shape of a human leg. Enraged and envious beyond belief, Rod seized his dark shears and clipped his wife's brutal rear into a coffee table. "That'll fix it," thought Ron, and he was wrong. The following Wednesday, he's never had his bushy grace like hair cut and burned into one with Queen Elizabeth who went sailing. Everywhere we went, people said, "Hooray!" Sometimes you just can't win.
Shouting near the gate. One of the dwarves has caught a fox.